let me take this opportunity to welcome you all to the historic First Presbyterian Church of Port Gibson and to the first of many graduation exercises for the 128th senior class of Chamberlain Hunt Academy. Chamberlain Hunt began on this campus back in 1879. And the tradition of senior speeches goes back, well, at least that far. Last speaker of the evening, Professor Rem Alexander Paredes, will tell us about Tooth Fairy, the Easter Bunny, Global Warming.
You should not be afraid of global warming. The Earth's climate moves in cycles. totally vulnerable. It has been doing so for thousands of years. We should not be afraid of natural changes that may very well bring benefits. Do not be manipulated by someone's hidden agenda and do not feel fear something is natural and beneficial.
Final pass and review. The final pass and review is a time-honored tradition in which the Corps of Cadets assembles for the final time and reward deserving young men and women for their academic and military accomplishments during their time at Chamberlain Hunt Academy. I now present to you the 2007-2008 Chamberlain Hunt Academy Corps of Cadets.
Attention! State University occupies the site today. The proceeds from the sale were used by the Presbytery of Mississippi to found Chamberlain Hunt Academy. The academy's name honors Dr. Jeremiah Chamberlain, the founder and the first president of Oakland College, and Mr. David Hunt, a very generous benefactor to that institution. Housed at first in the annex of Port Gibson's Presbyterian Church, the academy moved to its current campus in 1900. A military department was included in 1895, and the academy became a full military school in 1917. It has been a member of the Southern Association of Colleges and Schools since 1911, and it is a charter member of the Mississippi Private School Association. Ask everyone please rise for the invocation. Let us pray. Our Lord, we confess today that you are the mighty triune God. You reveal yourself to us through the scriptures. We thank you that you work all things for the good of those who love you. We thank you that you have preserved Chamberlain Hunt for 128 years, during good times and bad. We thank you for the teachers you've called here to teach. We thank you for the staff you have called here to work. We thank you for calling French Camp Academy to be our partners in ministry and education. Our Heavenly Father, we pray your blessings on this academy. We pray that you continue to send to us the cadets, faculty, and staff whom you desire to be here. Give us all a vision of holiness that we might long to be pure and free from sin. Protect us from the temptations that surround us, and give us hearts that long to obey you. Most of all, we thank you for your only Son, Jesus. Because he died, those who trust in him live. Because he lives, we know that all his people will live with him forever. Because he is our shepherd, we know that we are safe from all harm. Because he is our King, we know that we have no need to fear. Father, give us your Holy Spirit, that we may know your presence and grow more and more into the likeness of Christ. For it is in his name that we pray. Amen.
Order!
We ask everyone please to stand for the presentation of the colors and the playing of the national anthem.
Not sure where to begin. I would hope that you're mindful of our speech this morning. A lot of thoughts pass through my mind as I stand before you on the final time. What should I say? What do I see in front of me? What are the thoughts running through my head? I would tell you that my thoughts first run to the cadre, and then I hope that they would be mindful of their calling and the hope that's within them, that they may be able to do that which is required. I hope that they remember that discipline is central in one's own life and in the life of this academy. I'm reminded of a story of a great man, General Washington. In the book Sacred Fire, there's a story told. The story goes something like this. A rider on horseback many, many years ago came upon a squad of soldiers who were trying to move a heavy piece of timber. A corporal stood over them giving loud orders. Heave! Heave! But the piece of timber was too heavy and it wouldn't move. The stranger on horseback said, "Why don't you help them?" "Me? Why? I'm a corporal, sir." Dismounting, the stranger carefully took place with the soldiers. "Now all together, boys, heave!" And the big piece of timber moved into place. The stranger mounted his horse and he addressed the corporal. "Next time you need a piece of timber moved, men, you need to handle it. Corporal, you send for the commander in chief." And the horseman rode off. That horseman was George Washington. In that, we need to be humble. As a staff, we need to guard our mouths. We need to be disciplined and have a work ethic and be about the task that we're called here to deal with. The idea of making boys into men, the ideas of providing quality education and understanding the truth. I want to close. And I know it's rather troubling, and the historian on the podium with me will find it troubling that I might want to paraphrase General Washington's words, but I find them appropriate for this place, this time in history, and the life of our schools. General Washington's prayer at Valley Forge is my prayer for you here. I consider it an indispensable duty to close out the last act of my official life at Chamberlain Hunt by commending the interests of our dear academy to the protection of Almighty God and to those who have the superintendence of it into its holy keeping. Cadets, be fearless men. Be mindful of your calling that Christ may be magnified in you, whether it be in life or whether it be in death. Remember, press towards that mark which Christ has set before you. Godspeed. As the valedictorian of the class of 2008, 128th graduating class of Chamberlain Hunt Academy, the valedictorian for the class of 2008 is Chase Whittemore.
I've heard it said, I do not believe in pessimism. If something doesn't come up the way you want, forge ahead. And if you think it's going to rain, it will. Cadre, family, friends, and cadets, it's been one long haul from beginning of high school till now. Along the road, there have been many obstacles and mountains that we've had to climb. Though the path may have been muddy, still we have had to forge ahead. Oftentimes, when looking forward, all we could see was the dark of an unexpected storm. For many long waiting periods, we simply felt that we were in the silence before the storm. However, today's skies seem clear. When I first embarked on this journey at Chamberlain Hunt Academy, I was a small sophomore, staring straight ahead at a huge task before me. My first year was a blur, as it is for many, with only the remembrance of the good times with friends. But one thing that will always stick with me is the first time I stepped on this campus, my dad waved goodbye. It almost defines us. When our parents leave, we feel a sense of independence, yet it's intertwined with a great fear of the unknown. There are many that I can thank for encouraging me through these struggles here. My parents are first of all. They were always there for me, and I know they always will be. Second are my fellow classmates. Seniors, we have been through it all, through the blood, sweat, and tears. We have been there for each other. We know everything about one another, which always isn't a good thing, but it allowed us to help one another through the hard times. Now all that is past, and graduation is before us. All the worries of exams and comps are gone, and the anxiety of freedom is present. We have longed for this day as long as I can remember, and we will cherish it for years to come. Underclassmen, I hope that as a senior class, we have set a worthy example of what it takes to be a godly leader. And I pray that you will do the same when you are called upon. We've all heard many times to do everything to the best of our ability, all the time. This quote has influenced me since the first time I've heard it. I hope that you as well receive and understand its true importance today. As you look around, you can feel the sense of accomplishment among us. We have finally made it to the end, and as we leave this place, take to heart all that you have done. Use what you have learned to help those around you, and I challenge you to take the road less traveled, and to look to God for direction, because only through Him is the way of righteousness. I'm going to miss y'all. Yes, even you, Colonel Blaine. And I thank you for the influence you've had on my life. Thank you.
At this time, seniors, please come forward to receive your diplomas. Leland Christopher Barber. Justin Michael Von Billion. Scott Braddock. Christopher Campbell Callahan. Stephen David Duaron. Thomas Bradley Fulton. Robert Logan Medusia. Ren Alexander Paredes. Stephen Jacob Probst. This concludes our 128th year and our 2007-2008 final pass and review.
The road is long with a man. not share. And the load doesn't weigh me down.
Alex and Josh say this is the best candy store in the world. D14, gate D14 in Dallas. They stop here every time they come home.
People, they have bar mitzvahs, and it's kind of a rite of passion for their young men. Well, Alex has just turned 18. He's graduated high school. He submitted his life to the Lord, and I just want to let you know what a blessing he has been, having a son like Alex who loves the Lord. Before, I haven't really shared this with that many people, but when I was getting ready to marry Alex and
we were a package.
He missed the message this morning.
He was a handful.
I asked myself, and I actually prayed to God, God, do I really want to do this? I'm 42 years old. Do I want another child? And as sure as I heard of, something from deep inside me, I heard God say, you know what? He's going to bless you more than you could ever bless him. And it's been true. So, I just want to tell you, Alex, you've been a blessing to me. You're a godly man, and I'm so proud of you.
Alex has always been a blessing to me. It's a blessing to see Alex around the living desert, just whipping through and all the things that he did and helped with. And it's wonderful to think of his new life. I wish him great success with it. I know we'll have it. Someday he'll be back. He'll be the director of the Living
That
Desert
could be.
Zoo. It's the truth.
I'd just like to say to Alex, if there's any wisdom we can give you, it's that in everything you say and everything that you do, do all to the glory of God.
Amen. Amen.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Yeah. We've got a bunch of pastors here. Lay hands on them and pray for them.
Lord, thank you for Alex. Lord, thank you for the way you work in people's lives and you change us, Lord. Thank you for that. And Lord, we just pray that you continue to bless Alex and may he be used greatly for your ministry and cause to change many lives as you work through. Thank you for it.
Lord, your word says that the eyes of the Lord go to and fro throughout the earth looking for one man that would stand in the gap on behalf of the people. Make Alex that man, we pray, Lord. Just fill him with a double portion of your Holy Spirit. Use him mightily. May his life bring glory to you, Father, in Jesus'
name. Thank you, Lord. Amen.
Lord, we do thank you for this young man. And Lord, it's been a while since I've seen him, and I see the growth in him, the countenance that he has. And Lord, we know that comes from you. So we pray, Lord, that you would continue to have your hand upon him, that you would strengthen him in any weakness that he might have, that he would be used by you mightily to affect the lives of people that he prays.
Dear Heavenly Father, we sure thank you for Alex responding to your call. The call of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And Father, we just pray that you give Irene and Alex safe travel throughout his mission trip. And just be with them and just put in Alex's heart to continue to witness that Jesus is the Lord.
Yes. Yes.
Lord, when I think of Alex, I just think of meekness. And that's something that you've given him. So we just pray, Lord, that you would use his gifts and just help him, Lord, to just walk with you all of his days, and just may he just sense your leading in his life.
Father, I thank you for my son, Lord. What a blessing to me and his mother, Lord. I just think of Alex as a shining example to his friends and the other young men, Lord. He can encourage them, Lord. And, thank you for a blessing in his life. Thank you.
Amen.
And everybody Amen. Said,
Amen. Amen.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.